Welcome to The Crow Show, with your hosts, VeracityTrigger, Infamous BC, and Zodiac.
How often do you honestly, or when it's windy, how often do you honestly think about flying a kite? I don't want to just fly a kite. I want to make a kite and fly a kite. Because that's way more fun than just flying a kite. Even if my kite looks like a piece of shit. Because it's just two sticks and some paper that I cut into a diamond shape.
Fishing, bro.
I want to do a lot more of that, too. But fishing leads to drinking.
I used to love fishing. I wasn't drinking. I was underage. But I never caught a goddamn thing, but I loved going out to the woods and fucking sitting at that lake.
Yeah, I have a lot of bad luck. There'll be days when I'll catch a few. But it always seems to be when it's catch and release.
I've never had that chance. I'm 33 years old. I've never caught a fish.
No lie, dude. You,
wow.
Yo,
seriously.
Just go to a catch and release stream and you watch. You'll catch a fish. I guarantee it. Because they choose.
We went camping back in like 2008 with that. My wife's like whole mother's side of the family. We took up like fucking 8 camping spots next to each other.
Yeah.
We took the boy down to the lake. Same lake I used to fish in. So I'm teaching him how to cast and fuck it. Reeling it in, getting nothing. Wife comes down. I'm like, here, take this. I'm going to go grab some more beer. Fucking, she proceeds to reel in fucking like a dozen fish. It's like, what? It was either the same stupid fish like, over and over again. Or
Jesus out here.
It's like, holy shit.
Yeah.
Just one after another.
Over Easter.
And then you come back and it's like,
yeah, exactly.
Like, screw this.
I just gave up at that point. You know what? Fuck it.
I'll watch you catch fish.
Yeah, I'm going to sit over here in the shady spot in the sand and I'm going to drink beers.
Mm-hmm.
No, you be dad for a while. No, you teach him how to fish.
Yeah. Zodiac, that's the same for me, though, too, because if I go fishing, I rarely catch fish. I'll catch one, maybe two. I think one time I got 3, but that was when I was like 10. I was 10 years old at the time.
Yeah, when I was younger and I would sit on the canoe, I would catch fish. I would just sit and like rock on a canoe for the longest time and let everything get really still. And I'd cast it in by like some trees where the trees dangled over and I'd catch fish. But every time I've been on like a motorboat trying to do like deeper fishing or any kind of deeper fishing, I never get luck.
I don't know what it is. You have to have some kind of affinity with fish, or maybe be a Pisces. Maybe that's it.
No, really, really, it's conditions. It's just conditions. I mean, really, that's what it comes down to. The reason that she reeled in all those fish is because all the fish at the same time got hungry again. I mean, that's pretty much it. It's just conditions.
I enticed them all to the surface with my bait.
I think it's all luck-based.
Well, that's what I'm saying. It's almost somewhat luck. Is when the fish, if you knew exactly when the fish were hungry, then yeah, you could cast in at the perfect time every time. But for the most part, if you're out there for 4 hours, they might have just been biting right before, and they will probably just bite right after. But those 4 hours that they are full, there is no reason for them to eat. They're just not. They're not like humans where they're like, oh, a snack.
Those fish are un-American.
Yeah.
Fish do not have
you
gluttonous.
Eat, goddammit.
There's no gluttony in fish, you know.
So you guys wanted to talk about favorite actors and actresses and stuff tonight? Do that?
That's what I was looking to do.
Alright.
Is that gonna be the only main topic? It's pretty much just like favorites and least favorites or favorites from childhood.
We could
really like you're I was absolute, gonna, like you're like you'll see anything this person's in.
I'd like to give Adam Sandler a shout out and how I used to like him. And how really does. Although I think he has some new movie coming out that I thought looked kind of funny.
See, I'm the opposite. I like his newer stuff.
Really?
Huh. Why?
There we go. Except Let's save it for the show.
Yeah, save it for the show.
Well, we are in the show.
I haven't started yet. I didn't think we were recording yet.
Well, I started quite some time ago.
We'll call that sound check. We've just been shooting the shit.
You usually do that.
Come on, make sure it's running. So, in case I forget. You know,
in case I forget,
it's already running.
Don't miss.
Well, it depends on how many shots I take. So. Oh man,
Oh man, I forgot to record the whole show.
All right, who's playing with?
I'm afraid I might do that at some point, and you guys are gonna be like, "You son of a bitch!"
Right, just because I always record them.
Okay, yeah, but you haven't put any up yet, man.
I haven't had time to fucking edit them, man. I'm a full-time college student. I work 30 hours a week. What do you want from me? You're lucky to do the show.
One of the things I want to talk about, and it's kind of the reasons why I got startled when you said you're going to be on the show, Trigger. What would you guys say if I started writing a blog? I've been watching Californication, so it could just be an impulse thing. But
yeah, go ahead, do it. Oh, and before we go any further, just going to start it up real fast.
It is 1998, so.
I'm just going to start up real fast by saying, yeah, we're talking about favorite actors, actresses tonight. BC wants to talk about least favorite too. That's okay.
I'm down with
or just honorable mentions, not necessarily least favorite, but just
sure.
You know, people that maybe impacted you in life.
Who shall not be named?
He that shall not be named. We can't talk about him though.
Yeah, we're not going to talk about him. No, that's fine.
He is banned.
I know.
But basically, we have myself, Trigger. We have I'm the Zodiac. We have infamous BC back here from the dead, and Sowsauce.
Yay!
That's cool how I came before Sowsauce in that introduction.
Right, like after Easter. Like,
well, I'm looking at the list of the names, so that's why I'm doing it.
Fuck you, Sowsauce.
I'm still in third, bitch. I come back after like 20 episodes.
you're immediately thumped up.
I don't know who my least favorite actor is. This infamous PC here.
I'd have to agree with you, Sal.
I like Denise Richards.
Oh,
has
yeah.
Has she done anything lately?
Is she in your top five? Like,
you know, I really only actually ever watched Denise Richards in that one James Bond movie, and I just thought she did a good job. I like every James Bond girl. I know.
But isn't she married to Chuck Norris? Is that who he married? No.
Denise Richards.
She wishes.
Who did he? I forget who he married now. Damn it.
Did he remarry or something? Wasn't that blonde chick? It was also. I remember her doing also the like the. Whatever,
yeah, she was doing the Bowflex commercial or whatever. Chuck Norris Power Thruster or whatever it was called.
Yeah.
You know, in all honesty, I really feel like Chuck Norris has a small penis. Despite all the nice things about him, no one's ever like Chuck Norris's penis is huge. I don't think so. I just don't think so. Not criticizing him. I think
he was super manly back in the day.
But I don't think he has a big penis. Is that the gated character?
Wait. How did we get on big penis topics? I thought we were talking about, okay.
So, it's all the above.
He is also a...
In fact, I'd like to know every single favorite actor's and how you feel about their penises. That's part of the questioning in the group of why they're your favorite actors. Like, he's definitely not a big schlong. We could talk about women's vaginas and pussies.
Oh, man. Whoa, this is getting way off.
We don't talk like that anymore.
Kat Dennings and Amanda Seyfried.
Jeez. I come back and this is like a...
Who's the second one? I know Kat Dennings.
Could I just say Archer fast? I would love does to that see count? Does Archer count for the anime? John Benjamin, the voice actor.
Oh yeah, John Benjamin.
Oh yeah,
count him.
Does that count? Because that's what I'm going to say. I mean, I watched that and
he's the same guy as Home Movies, right?
I want to.
He did voice work on Home Movies. He used to have a show on Comedy Central called John Benjamin as a Man. That was kind of funny.
I don't remember that. I would probably look that up now. But I remember he had another big role where he played. I like his voice. He's got a good voice.
But yeah, he's Bob on Bob's Burgers. He's Archer. Yeah. He's I can't remember his name, but the guy on Family Guy who runs the convenience store that Chris works at, he does his voice too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's like you hear that voice and you just, I know that voice.
Right? It makes you feel at home. It's comforting.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so I'm going to throw a wild card out there that probably nobody would expect, but I'm going to put Johnny Depp in my top five.
I thought we weren't saying. Yeah.
The biggest.
That. I'm gonna say it because I'm talking positive about him.
The biggest ass butt.
The man is a good actor.
Well, one of my
don't like him
five.
As a person. You, love you him as an that's actor. Bad?
My top five got Mel Gibson in it.
Hey,
people hate Mel Gibson.
You know what?
I don't care about his personal
Pre-Passion of the Christ, Mel Gibson. Outstanding.
Hey, you actually enjoyed that? I'm surprised.
I don't even think that he's been in anything.
I pretty much only like him in Braveheart.
Is he in Expendables?
The Gringo, Catch the Gringo or whatever.
Oh, yeah, that was funny, too.
That movie was actually cool, too.
I didn't see
that. I wish there was somebody else that played him.
Mad Max is the best.
I gotta throw Payback. Oh, yes, Mad Max, obviously.
You gotta love Mad Max.
Not so much the first one, but the second one.
The second one was great. Thunderdome, I don't remember too much, but the second one was probably his best performance.
Second one was definitely the best. Thunderdome, I would still put above the first one.
Yeah, well.
I like to imagine all these Hollywood celebrities are listening to this right now, and they're like, please say my name. Please say my name.
I could go on so and on.
I'm going to just also say Will Ferrell is going to be mentioned a little bit because I like Will Ferrell a lot.
I think Will Ferrell is
really funny. Mm-hmm. And I just think he's so creative, too.
Yep.
Yeah.
I had to throw Johnny Depp in there just because he's incredibly versatile.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
You can't deny it. The man can play dramatic, like, was it Transcendence?
Don't say his name one more time. You already said it twice.
Yeah, we should. We should IMDb every single person we mentioned to kind of remember who it is.
Gerard Butler.
Oh yeah,
see, I'd have to look at all the
top five.
Wait,
see,
off the top of my head,
I can't say.
Was he in that movie Gamers?
Or Gamer? Yeah, remember Gamer?
That is great.
Was that the one where they were in the game or something?
Yeah, where he was being controlled.
I never actually saw it.
It's actually really cool.
Yeah, yeah. They control people. You can let yourself be controlled by somebody else to get extra money. But usually that's like poor people that aren't at the higher end of society. So, convicts get controlled by gamers to be fought against each other. Because they're going to die anyway, so they might as well go out in a blaze of glory, I guess. So
they, after 30 wins, they get their freedom.
Supposedly, that's not supposed to happen, though.
Well, yeah, they're supposed to die before then. But if they win 30 times, they get their freedom.
Yeah. I'm going to Google a picture of Gerard Butler with Russell Crowe and just see what that looks like.
Almost identical.
All right, so would anybody know who Alan Tudyk is if I say that? That's one of my favorites. Alan Tudyk.
I
Wash on Firefly.
I was going to say that.
Okay.
Now, a lot of people... Yeah, he does a lot of voice work. I'll say that. It's not a lot of actual acting roles.
Does he do a lot of anime?
He's my favorite from, but he does... he does a lot of cartoons.
Hmm.
King Candy on Wreck-It Ralph. He's been on, like, frickin' Adventure Time, American Dad, Robot Chicken... I didn't see Rogue One.
I was
so going to
say Firefly.
K2SO is.
But. Well, if we'd got voice actors, I'll have to go with Johnny Botch and Crispin Freeman, hands down.
Well, he's also been on a lot of real shows too.
Johnny Botch was the Black Power Ranger when they changed him over.
I don't remember
in the first
series
when they switched the Black Ranger from being a black dude to an Asian dude, because it was racist to have the Black Ranger as the.
The black Ranger.
You made it the Asian.
The Black Ranger is the Black Ranger. How racist can you get?
Hey, are we doing favor? Are we doing favor?
The Asian girl was yellow.
Yeah.
Are we doing favorite actors and actresses, or are we just doing favorite movie stars?
Actors and actresses in general.
Right. Well, then I'd also like to give a shout out to Mia Khalifa. I think that she's a very funny, impressive person.
She is. It's sad I don't see her in too much, you know. The 70s show kind of propelled her a bit. I think Ashton Kutcher got propelled too far.
I think you're thinking
Mila Kunis.
Oh, yep. Oops. Okay, my bad.
No, this is a different person. Mila Kunis, I'll give her a shout-out, too. I actually think she's a really funny actress. I think that she always makes me laugh. Wasn't she in Ted, too? Was that, like, her biggest thing she ever
did? She was in the first Ted.
First, yeah. Ted also. I guess I should have said not Ted.
Yes.
Because there is a Ted too.
I wasn't that impressed with Ted too. The first one was pretty good, but the second one just seemed like it was... I could tell what was going to happen. I don't know.
Psychic. Is that the same with almost every second movie, though? Every second movie is just like a push of the first one, and then the third one's always like awesome again.
90% of the movies you see, you can just tell where everything's going to go.
Yeah. Well, I am pretty good at that, but I mean...
Like we were saying on a Life episode, I totally called Life, like, half an hour before the ending, I leaned over to my wife and like, yeah, this is exactly how it's going to end.
When I watch Shameless, I just think, what's the worst thing that's going to happen? Oh, there it is.
Yeah, right. When I watch Shameless, it's like, oh, what's my dad going to do next?
Yeah.
That's basically all. That's a lot of memories for me.
Man. You know, if I have to go for favorite actress, I'd have to basically say that it's between two different actresses, and I'm not totally sure. But I always like these two the best. One of them is Mila Jovovich, and the other one is Charlize Theron. Those two actresses, I think, are probably my absolute favorites.
Are you based off like their ability to actress, or just their movies, or what they how they choose to act? What are you?
They can do like Charlize Theron. She can do some bad guy characters. She can do good characters. She can
I think Charlize Theron's probably a better actress.
And Devil's Advocate better than any movie I've ever seen.
Oh, her in Devil's Advocate?
She was his wife, Keanu Reeves' wife.
Yeah.
Future wife.
Yeah.
And she just slowly went batshit crazy during the entire movie. And she should have got a fucking Oscar for that role.
Yeah. That was amazingly good. That was a great movie that nobody really talks about much. Devil's Advocate is so good. I mean,
that is one of those great movies that you never hear anybody say anything about.
Yep.
I mean,
Devil's Advocate?
Like, yeah, the way that they portray it.
Nobody I've ever talked to, like in real life, has ever seen the movie Heat.
Oh.
Any of you guys?
You know, actually, I never did. I
was thinking Dead
to,
Heat when you said that.
those four guys in the cover.
No, I think you're thinking of No, Heat's not four guys undercover. There's one guy undercover.
On the cover of the video.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I know what your movie you're talking about. I saw, you know why? Because there's a preview of it in some of my old VHS I have, like, or something. Like, maybe it was, like, Training Day or something.
I still have it on DVD.
Or Snatch. Yeah, I think it was Snatch, the beginning on Snatch. Which, there's another actor I really like. Can't think, what's his name? Jason Statham.
Yeah.
Like him.
Yes.
Statham's good.
Oh, man. And Mean Machine? You guys never watched Mean Machine, I bet. I love that freaking movie.
Jason Statham's pretty good, but I feel like his ability to branch out is kind of limited. He mostly just plays like a fighter.
He's an action star movie.
Or a driver.
But, yeah. He makes a great action star.
He's a great action star, but I don't. I couldn't see him being a comedian or anything like that. Like, he can't branch out too far like some other actors can.
I don't think I'd want to see him as a comedian, just as I wouldn't want to see Dave Chappelle as, like, a hardcore...
An action star.
Right.
Well, like, what is the other guy?
Yeah,
another guy.
Dave Chappelle sliding across a hood, shooting people. Ah!
I could not imagine Dave Chappelle as an action star.
That would be
Everything
weird.
He'd say, I'd be like, what are they going to do now?
I can't even do that.
But
bitch!
What's the name of the other actor in the other guys besides Will Ferrell? He's one of my favorites.
Mark Wahlberg.
Does comedy. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He does comedy and he does action. I mean, he can do both.
I feel like Shooter is a very underrated movie.
It is.
I really enjoyed it.
It's a very underrated movie.
I mean, I could call bullshit on it all day. Like when he had the plastic, the water bottle silencer. That's only gonna work once. But it kept shooting. After the first bullet, like, come on, dude. It's not a real silencer. That's going to muffle the sound once, and it's just going to sound like a plastic bottle exploding.
Yeah. And everybody always thinks, like, silencers, like, completely silence your guns and stuff. That's completely off topic.
That's okay.
No, but.
I just remember an article a long time ago.
It's supposed to be suppressors.
They don't actually.
Yeah.
They're never called silencers. It's only in games that they'll.
Name That's silencer. Movies and games. Yeah.
Yeah. They don't silence. They muffle and reduce the muzzle flash, so you aren't as easily noticed. But if you're within what?
From animals.
Like 30 yards.
Aren't as easily noticed.
A human
from animals.
Will hear that fucking round come out of that shit.
Speaking of deadly killers, also
animals
my top
will hear that round.
John Connery.
Sean Connery, yeah. Oh hell
Sean
yeah.
Sean Connery, hell yeah.
Fucking Bond.
I'm a
the
big
Rock.
James Bond fan, so Sean
the
Connery.
Did you see
awesome.
Him?
I love The Rock. It's one of my favorite movies ever.
That's
actually,
great.
I never watched that.
That is great. did you see
Highlander.
Him in the Highlander movies?
All of them.
Yeah, wasn't? Yeah, he was in the first one, right?
He was in two of them. The other one wasn't rated so well, and it wasn't really wasn't that great. But like the first one, like he was the previous teacher of Connor McLeod.
Yeah.
Right.
I think his name was Ramirez, or what was his
yeah,
name?
He was a Scottish guy playing a Spaniard.
I know. But
oh, it was ludicrous, but it was awesome.
Did you see, oh, did you see one of his oldest films?
A Scottish guy playing a Russian.
Did you see one of his
October?
Oldest films? He was this. It was a really strange movie. It's called like Zathura or something like that, but. It was a really weird-ass film, and it was an artistic film, where he plays as this death dealer, and he has to go around just killing random people, because this godhead tells him to go and kill all these people. And his godhead floats through the air, and it's one of those 70s movies. It's super strange, and it's got all these weird artistic themes to it, but I don't know if you ever saw that.
I know the movie you're talking about, but I've never seen it.
Okay.
I have no clue what you're talking about.
I think I skimmed past it at the Red Box or something.
It starts with a Z. It's super weird and interesting to watch. I don't know if you're going to like it or hate it, but like, it was one of those futuristic artistic things they did for the 70s. You know,
so,
one of those.
So I want to name some really good actors, and one of them also is Bill Murray.
Like, Bill fucking yeah. Murray.
Bill Murray. Like, come on. I mean, if you want to talk about a guy who can like play so many... Yeah,
what
I
about
guess he's
Bob?
Not that extreme, but
what about Bob? I love
he
that
has,
movie.
He hasn't done a lot of serious
sailing.
Stuff. Yeah,
dude, I like Bill Murray from Caddyshack.
But you guys,
dude, Scrooged. That's all I gotta say.
Scrooged. Oh God, that's my favorite Christmas.
That's
movie.
That's
yes,
good, but
that is also one of my favorite. I haven't been able to watch it with my kid yet because he still gets freaked out by death and the taxi cab.
I see what you
ghost,
guys
but...
are trying to do. I see what you're trying to do. You want me to untie the knots. Inside me. That's what you want me to do.
Yeah.
Bob, where did you put the bomb? It's inside
Bill,
the house.
I don't remember exactly. I think it was Zombieland, but wasn't Bill Murray in one of them zombie movies? Where
yeah, yeah.
Zombieland. Yeah, that's where I got the Bill fucking Murray thing from.
Yeah,
Bill fucking Murray. I'm like, sorry, I know that's not your middle name.
And that's the best part about it. Like, he just has to play himself in movies like that. He's like, I'm smart.
Put some fucking Ghostbusters.
Yep. Yeah, Ghostbusters, yep.
You know you're good at something when you can use your own name
Stripes.
In the movie.
Yo,
just
I know,
the facts, Jack.
I know you guys is a rare one, so you guys probably haven't seen it. Maybe you have or you didn't like it, but Life Aquatic. That movie changed my life.
With Steve Zissou.
Steve Zissou, man. I saw his name in a Rocket League game. Somebody with Steve Zissou.
Nice.
I didn't like the Tenenbaums, but I liked that. Yeah, what he wants in the.
I never made it through that movie. I tried watching it like 3 times.
No, yeah, that one was too slow. But yeah, what he wants through that water, and he's like, swamp leeches, everybody check yourselves. And nobody else has any, and he has them all, he's like all over him. It's like, what? I don't know. It's just a documentary. He does such a good job of making it like a depressing old man doing a documentary. Like he does.
Oh, yeah, he's
does.
Making fun of Jacques Cousteau.
Yeah, those 60s. I actually never noticed that. So.
Oh, that's the whole premise.
I always thought it was great anyway.
Still a good movie.
Shout out to Robin Williams.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, Robin Williams, yeah.
My favorite for him was definitely the Mork and Mindy show. I don't know if you ever watched that.
Oh my Christ, Mork and Mindy. I grew up on that was like my introduction to Robin Williams.
It was like you had to watch Mork and Mindy. It was like such a like a home bodied, good feeling kind of show to watch. I mean he just
oh, it's
knew
old,
how to
it's classic sitcom.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yep.
What was about the Crazy Ones? Did you guys ever watch that?
What?
If you haven't seen the Crazy Ones, it's fucking hilarious, and it's on Netflix now. Because I just watched it all. But I used to watch it when the show was new on TV, but then he kind of killed himself before season two, so there's only one season, but it's awesome.
Was Robin Williams a main character on Saturday Night Live? Or did
I don't
he just
think he was ever a cast member.
Guests?
Yeah, he was maybe a guest once or twice.
He was a guest once in a while. He was never...
He hosted a few times.
He was kind of too big to be a main character.
Yeah, that's true.
Will Ferrell started on Saturday Night Live when Saturday Night Live was starting. So Will Ferrell got famous from Saturday Night Live.
Will Ferrell's first skit that he introduced people was he pretended to be a cat playing with a ball. And then he also did a skit yelling at the kids to get off the shed. He just kept saying, "Can you get off the shed, please? Dad, get the fuck off the shed." Well, I don't think he swore, but you know, he's
fun.
But that cat playing with
Yeah, I think I did
I've
see
seen both
that.
Of those. They're both fucking hilarious.
Yeah.
What I love about Will Ferrell is he still does stupid shit like Funny or Die. Like he doesn't need to make videos on Funny or Die. But he fucking does.
He's just funny.
Yeah.
Like, that's awesome. He's this fucking star. He's definitely made enough money where he doesn't have to do internet videos.
All right, let's all rate his best film from best to least.
Will Ferrell.
Yeah.
He's been in a bunch of movies, but my favorite was probably Step Brothers.
That was good. That's I'd say good, other guys.
I'm gonna have to go Anchorman.
Anchorman.
It's one other of those guys. Two. Step Brothers. What do I got? Two left. Old School. And I'm gonna say Everything Must Go because that was an outstanding movie.
Mm-hmm.
Even though he wasn't funny in it.
IMDb is really getting really hard for me to freak.
Have you guys seen Everything Must Go?
I don't remember. I don't think I did see that one.
He's playing a serious role. He's an alcoholic. His wife kicks him out. And he's got like 72 hours to vacate the premises, and she put all his shit outside on the lawn. So he just sets it up like his living room and proceeds to just drink for the whole weekend.
Yeah.
People start coming by thinking it's a yard sale, and he just starts selling his shit.
Oh, man.
Some of it's funny, and then it's also, you know, really sad, but it's a good movie.
I have to say 5. I was trying to look through this, damn, but there's so much crap.
Damn, son, I did my top 5 off the top of my head.
Well, I just didn't want to forget something. You guys named them all.
Well, I didn't name my top 5, actually. I just named
your top 5.
All right, well, that's going to... I didn't really prepare for this.
That's what I'm saying. It's too tough.
I'd have to say, as far as guy actors go, probably Bruce Campbell is one of the top. Bruce Campbell, whatever.
I thought you said we were ranking Will Ferrell.
Yeah. Will Ferrell?
Are we doing our? I thought, we've been working through our top 5 favorites. Bruce Campbell, I will say, is awesome, but he's not in my top 5.
Mila Jovovich. Therese, Cameron,
Charlize Theron.
Well, dyslexia is jumping.
She's my
here.
Favorite, but I can't say.
Who else? Well, I mean, Ryan Reynolds probably, you know, got a spot because of Deadpool, probably.
I would throw Ryan Reynolds probably close. Close to, I'd say maybe a 6. I don't know if
I think he's
top
a
5.
Really funny. Good actor, but I just don't like him because I genuinely think he's really cocky. I believe him that he's this cocky person. Maybe he's a good person.
No, but that's one of the reasons cocky. I like him, though, man. He's super cocky. But he plays
What's
it so
funny
well.
Is he's actually not a cocky
And I never saw Deadpool, so...
He is a really down-to-earth person.
Have you ever seen him on any of his interviews and everything? Like, he's a super... chill, down to earth dude. He's not all cocky. He just plays.
You can't pull off all that cockiness from Deadpool without having some of that.
I mean, that's like
I disagree with that. That's kind of their job.
Nah, you can't act. You can only act who you are. In a sense, you have to tap into being that person.
Yeah, that's what I think too.
If you're not believe, you don't believe in that kind of person, you can't do it.
I mean, that's why I think BC too. Yeah. I think you can be.
I think he's just amplifying.
Yeah, I mean, amplifying. But anyone's cocky. Like, it's something.
The way that I talk online and on the show here, this is pretty much how I am in real life too. Like, I'm not incredibly cocky, but you know, I don't feel bad about my opinions and all that shit. I'm gonna say what I want.
Yeah, just like that's the same for me. I don't, you know, I'm not gonna cry a fucking river if I
But if somebody does something stupid, I'm gonna call them out on it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I enjoy calling people out on dumb shit.
Oh yeah.
It's fun.
It's the little things.
You know, I really used to like George Clooney a lot, but then he started really getting into that whole like Trump's not my president thing.
I never liked George Clooney.
And now I just have like no respect for him anymore.
I was never a Clooney fan.
Well, I really liked
He'd be in my top 40. He'd
Oh brother, where art thou?
He's got acting skills, he's got the face, he's got the looks, but never thought.
Well, it was mostly like terrible. I always wanted to like play a game of poker with like George Clooney and Brad Pitt and all them other people. I just thought that'd be like a lot of fun.
Did you guys ever see The Men Who Stare at Goats?
Yeah, I did. I don't really remember that.
That's a good Clooney movie. I like that one. It's fucking weird.
Well, he's cocky too, you know? He's cocky, so it's like you don't like his cockiness though, apparently.
Why is that? Honestly, he's just not in a lot of movies that I like.
No, it's just it's his character.
I wasn't an ER fan, so I didn't really
get into Clooney early.
His character is kind of bland. I don't know. It just seems kind of bland.
But he did the voice in for Mr. Fox and Fantastic Mr. Fox.
And you like know more. Role. I mentioned him, and you guys know more about him. Jeez, at least you do. So.
I watch a lot of movies.
Yeah, I do too.
I was just basing off of his looks.
Oh, we talking top five actors we'd blow? I mean,
well, BC was talking about that a little bit earlier, like wasn't he?
Well,
because Ryan Reynolds jumps up to number one in that list.
Ryan Reynolds now does hit my top five.
Yeah, he's broken out of the top 10 and into the top five now. Johnny Depp doesn't make that list, though.
I think it's all those Pirates of the Caribbean movies that make you kind of go, eh.
Oh, Ryan Gosling also takes that top five. Bradley Cooper will take that top five. Wait, I'm getting too late. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I'm not going any further than one.
I thought we were all doing top five here.
Hey, I gave my top four.
Ava Mendes is in my other top five. We're going the other way here, you know. I like Ava Mendes.
I will say Mila Jovovich will make that list.
She probably would make that list, yes.
Yep.
It'd be tough, though, to pick top five. You love them all.
She does such an amazing job, whatever she does.
I do like her as an actress, but I hope she's done doing Resident Evil movies.
I liked her, Mila Jovovich.
Like 7 movies ago, I wish she was done doing
Mila Jovovich. Was she in now I can't.
Fifth Element?
No. Was that who she was?
She was in Ultraviolet.
Yeah, she was Lulu.
It was like her big breakout role.
The Fifth Element, yeah.
Dazed and Confused.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That one too. I think The Fifth Element really pushed her a little bit further, though, because she really worked that movie.
And I don't think she showed her boobs in that movie, which I think is a first for her.
Every single actor.
Side boob, yeah.
For the movie Dazed and Confused needs like a shout out. Matthew McConaughey. Who's that other guy?
McConaughey, I can never be sure if I like him or not.
Dude, that guy I'm
with you on that one, Zodiac.
I heard he doesn't even wear deodorant because he just doesn't smell. That's what I heard. I'm just saying. I mean, the guy to me seems like a cool guy. I'd like to.
Man, you're gay for McConaughey.
Yes, I would like to kick it with Matthew McConaughey.
I mean, I just have a feeling he's going to be like, all right.
Jim Carrey.
Dude. Remember, Matthew McConaughey was Leonardo DiCaprio's boss in that one movie. Yeah. You know, like, think about that. Like, he's been around the block. He knows. Leonardo DiCaprio.
It's tough to. Dude, he's a fucking phenomenal actor. And has been maybe
I will
a
say DiCaprio
for his whole life.
He was nobody liked him at first except for young girls.
Come on.
No. I liked the
real
Basketball Diaries.
He was awesome.
Dude, Basketball Diaries was an old movie and I saw him in that and I was like, "Yo, this guy's good."
I haven't seen it.
He plays a heroin addict, kid heroin addict. They take all
honestly, I think the earliest movie I remember seeing him in was
so good.
Gilbert Grape,
yeah.
He went full retard.
Well, he's kind of the same way in that in Basketball. He's just like really messed up. He didn't really start getting into more like, dude, The Aviator. Like, he was fucking badass. Catch Me If You Can.
That one was good.
The movie was awesome.
I never saw the first one, but
Gangs of New York is another one I've never seen the whole movie. I've seen like the first half.
Oh, I fucking love that.
Yeah, I don't know if I've ever seen Gangs of New York. There's a lot of.
Yeah. I think he's good, but I mean, he's a Scorpio.
I thought he was
so
good as Gatsby.
Most of them are good, anyways.
I will say, I did enjoy Great Gatsby as a movie.
Great Gatsby was surprisingly good.
They
I wasn't
stuck
really
pretty close to the actual story, and I that was one of the books that I read as a kid that I actually loved.
Yeah, besides the whole rap scene they had in the middle that, you know,
yeah,
pulled you a little bit too far forward into an artistic form, it was really good. I mean, you know,
the rap scene did not fit except for that weird rap scene at the party.
Exactly. It's like they threw in this artistic piece in there. It was like, this doesn't really fit because it's not an artistic movie. It's trying to, like, portray the book. And then they, like...
Yeah, and I don't think they had Jay-Z in the 20s.
Yeah, I scratched my head on that one.
I'm sure they had Jay-Z-like people.
Are you talking about black people, Brad?
I wasn't going to go there.
Wow. Okay.
I was just more like saying, like, musicians.
Yeah, they were there.
if you count Jay-Z as
music became art.
I think
it was like in the late 80s.
The Renaissance 90s. Era?
No. Music is not art. It's music. I'm sorry. Art is something someone creates with paint.
Well, then probably like the 90s when they rechanged all those
like
books
modern,
to just combine,
I
to combine
music
art.
Is art.
Modern art. There was some kids who pranked a modern art gallery in LA. They put a pair of glasses on the ground by the wall, and people were stopping to take pictures of the art.
Yeah,
but that's all. I'll say I'm sorry.
Yeah, I don't know. Like
that's modern art, and people are weird.
Modern art, I don't get. Like, you know, I've seen some modern art in the past when it was like a red dot painted on a big canvas. And I was like, that's just a red dot. And later on, I've seen things where they just paint the whole canvas white. So it's like, well, you could have just left it blank and that would have been fine too.
No, the real painting's underneath.
it's how it moves you.
Modern art is.
As I live in an artist community.
Modern art
is
bullshit.
That's what this town is fucking famous for. Like this 90% of the street that I live on is art galleries.
Modern art is just how much a person will pay for whatever somebody else did.
And you know what's the thing?
There is literally an art gallery underneath my apartment.
Dude, I'll tell you right now, if you put the price up higher, more people want it. It's just the way it is. They're like, oh, this is worth that much. Okay, this must be really good. That's how people.
The guy across the street from me has some talent. He does some really cool like stuff with neons and metallic paints, and then he has this other weird method that he created, I guess, that he calls dolloping. Where he puts like a blob. He puts a blob of oil paint on there and uses it to like.
Dude, don't even make
flowers.
He's don't even make that word popular there. Because sooner or later it'll be like, oh,
oh it's going to be a
you dab, bro. Dude, I dollop, man.
No, that's a real thing, though. Like, when I did oil paintings, I did some of that. I'd use a knife, and I'd just take the glob, and I'd sort of form stuff.
That's what
the,
he does, yeah.
With
and
the knife.
He does these, like, 3D, he does these awesome, like, 3D sunflower paintings with it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to make videos of me dolloping
that's
in different
not
places.
Bad, but
it'll
it's
basically
like, if you just have art that's, like, just a flat canvas, and there's nothing on it, or it's like a red dot, it's like, come on. Do something there. No, don't waste my time. Just looking at it, I'm wasting my time looking at this thing.
I don't know art, but I know what I like.
if it doesn't even look interesting and it just looks like something you could copy-paste from the internet, then what's the point?
Yeah.
You it's know? The artist. What the person
maybe it
wants
was,
to
maybe
do for
it
the
was
artist.
Just a blank canvas and there was a sniper aiming at it.
Oh, well, thanks. That helps me now. I can
someone
visualize
was
this.
It was Mark Wahlberg.
I just fucking
looking three parking structures away.
Samuel L. Jackson.
I like
yeah.
that
yeah.
guy.
I like Morgan
guy.
Freeman a little better.
I feel like it's a cop out to put him in a
better
top
than
five
what?
List, though.
Black actor?
Then Sam Jackson.
Morgan Freeman's better than Samuel Jackson.
Yes.
Yeah.
Morgan Freeman, hands
no
down.
No way.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, like, Morgan Freeman's cool. I want to give him his props. That guy's got an amazing voice, and he really found a way to, and he used it. I mean, dude, how many things that recorded in Morgan Freeman's voice? And I like to listen to it. Not talking down, but Samuel
But I wouldn't
Jackson
say he's one
actor,
of my favorites, though, yeah.
But Samuel Jackson is an actor. That guy, the Django Unchained, I mean, he's okay. willing to play his role because he knows that he just looks like a crazy black man.
Faithfully.
Okay, so Pulp Fiction, he probably takes the cake for that.
Oh my
Pulp,
Christ.
Oh my Pulp gosh, Fiction. Yeah, Pulp yeah. Fiction. Die Hard with a Vengeance.
Divine Intervention.
Man, that is
Which,
a mighty
I think
tasty
was, I think
burger.
It was I think it was infamous
Denzel
that Paul announced
Washington.
Him first when that
yeah,
all
Denzel
the whole
Washington
were actually behind where he was standing.
Will Smith in my top five favorite actors.
No.
No
Fresh Prince.
So cool.
The TV
Will,
show,
Will
yeah.
Smith is a great guy. You know, I that's what I'll say about him.
I think
I mean,
this took us 5 degrees to get here or something like that. But Will Smith was in iRobot and Alan Tudyk did the voice of, what was it, Sammy? The main robot that they were questioning.
Yeah, Sammy.
Yep, that was Alan Tudyk.
Nice.
Will Smith always tried to be positive, in my opinion. At least what I think of him.
Yeah, I'd say Will Smith
I just
is pretty good.
Am not a huge Will Smith fan as an actor. Like, he's okay, but he wouldn't make my top five.
I think he was greater when he was younger. I think he's still
I
doing
think
well.
I like him
more as he got older.
I disagree. I think he is so much of
a He's another one. I like him way better now than I liked his older stuff.
I liked Independence Day. I'd say that is probably his
yeah,
best.
Yeah, it's Independence Day, definitely. That I don't know if it was Enemy his best, but it was damn good. Enemy of the State was a really good one.
So Independence Day is best performance.
That was that movie? Was it
yeah,
movie?
I wouldn't say Independence Day
a,
was his best.
Trigger,
but
trigger,
it was
trigger.
I'm
like,
not
I'll
a huge
put it up there with
Alien
Men in Black.
Fan, but that
Trigger.
When he was in it, I think that was his best.
Trigger, what was that movie where he played with Charlize Theron and they were superheroes? Or sort of.
Hancock.
You didn't like that one?
Awesome.
Come on, it's got,
it's
got one of your favorite girls.
He was an
oh,
alcoholic
man.
Superhero. That was great.
That was awesome.
I don't remember that one that well.
If she's willing to play a thing with him, he's got to be a good guy, right? I mean, right?
I saw that movie... at the drive-in, actually. I saw Hancock and then Step Brothers right after it.
I don't know why they chose to make that movie
Hancock,
called
Hancock. But I can't remember anything about it now.
If you're going to make a movie called Hancock, I think it'd be more cooler to be like,
based
John
on a
Hancock.
Comic.
I don't know. Hancock.
it's another one based on a comic.
It was never supposed to be a name. I don't know.
You guys like Sam Jackson the best. So you like, Breakable?
He already said it.
What was the one?
Washington.
No.
Unchained.
Ooh, Unbreakable. Such, oh, I love that movie.
Unbreakable, where
him and Bruce Willis.
Where he's like glass. He can break it anytime, and Bruce Willis was in there.
That movie. Such
That's
a
where
movie.
Sam Jackson never really did the best.
Why did him and Bruce Willis never make the freaking sequel to that? Why? They did so many movies together.
It is one of those back alley movies that's really good, but everybody's like, ah, well, it didn't get great performance, so we're not going to go watch it.
Why? But yo, come on, tell me if they would. LA. Tell me, yo, as soon as he takes off his glove at the end and they shake hands and he's like, now you know. And it just made it like, yo, he becomes the villain. And it would have been so fucking awesome to see him play his rollout and him play his rollout. Oh my gosh, they made the perfect backstory. The best fucking backstory ever.
I know. It's basically like a real life comic book thing come to life, but that's even better because it's more realistic. It's like you could really believe this over like Marvel movie stuff. Like seriously, really believe it. Like this guy, he can't
get
hurt.
You know what? You know what I think it was? I think they must have known that they were already getting older, and if they did it now, it's gonna fail. So they're just gonna let it ride out till they find two other people to play those roles when they're younger.
No, they can't redo it with that. Come on.
You have to. It's the only way. No, it's the only way because look at it. Bruce Willis is old, and so is Samuel. They can't be superheroes and villains now. they'll look like Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy. You know, like.
Well, then why not?
That's all.
Why not? Come on. Why not?
I'm just saying it's going to play out. It has to eventually. That movie will have to have a sequel. It was
stubbing my motherfucking toe in this motherfucking invisible book.
You thought about it because you read it in the newspapers throughout the movie, like so many lives, like a train wreck and all these things, like a plane crash. You like read it in the newspapers and it's like it's all because this psychopath is killing everybody to find one person.
But yeah, BC, look at it. It was so well put together.
I gotta watch this movie.
It was so well put together. When he's going to like save the woman, he just randomly like draws upon it. You know, he just randomly finds her.
No, I've never seen Unbreakable.
Yo, but yo, and the kids, like the way yo, and that fight though, that fight was beast. It's
so dope.
Because I like real fights. Yo, I mean, he almost had him. He almost had him, man. Dropped him in the pool. Thought he was done. Movie over. Sorry. Movie came out a long time ago. It's still a good movie. I'd watch it again. You know another Samuel Jackson movie you probably never saw? 187. That movie was gangster, man. 187 with Cesar Sanchez or whatever his name was. Samuel Jackson. You ever seen this movie?
I don't think so.
I vaguely remember watching it like in high school, but
he plays a teacher
since I was a teenager.
Plays a teacher and he gets like shanked. They write 187 on his books and they shank him. And he lives, and he becomes a teacher again. And these kids,
what's
these
that?
Kids,
it's police code for homicide.
Yeah, yo, it's gangster, man. Yo, he decides to fight back. Yes, shit, he does to those fucking ghetto thugs.
Mm-hmm. Robert Downey Jr.
I was gonna throw Downey Jr. in there.
Oh yeah, I like him. I used to not like him, but I like.
I've
him.
Always liked him as an actor. Like, he was a shit show for a while.
For the longest time.
Yeah, like, but can you blame him?
Well, he's better.
Did he have a show that he was on a long time ago?
Downey Jr., like a TV show?
A talk show?
I don't think so.
I almost remember him being on a talk show.
He's an actor. They're always on talk shows.
When he came out with Iron Man.
Iron Man, I think, the hell else was he in before
Sherlock
that?
Holmes.
Sherlock Holmes was very good.
That brought him back.
He was
Sherlock
in rehab.
Sherlock Holmes is kind of underrated compared to Iron Man because
get all drugged up after every time he'd do a role.
Yeah. Well, it's tough, man. Hollywood and stuff like that, they're messed up, man. I feel bad for them. Look at all those Hollywood young kids that always seem to get messed up. Yo, Disney hires you, like, you got to think,
Well, we were talking about this actually in my literature.
Talk to Justin Timberlake if Disney hires you. Talk to Justin Timberlake and be like, "Why are you okay? And what, what happened with so many of these people?"
Justin,
like, I do not feel like turning 30 and shaving my head, or again going to rehab over and over and over again.
Dude, the only way you can get famous is if you turn 30 and shave your head. I mean, look at Look at the rack. Look at
Britney Spears had such a chance to
Britney
be a cool person.
I've shaved my head since I was fucking 20.
What? No, I'm just saying, like, she had a chance to become, like, dude, she was hot. She wasn't really not getting hot. And she had a hot young sister, too. It was like, they could have been, like, TV people doing car. Nope, sister's got to get pregnant. She's got to keep being a mess. You know, they were just like, can't.
Well, that's
what
I was
saying. We talked about it in my literature class earlier today, somehow. Like, with the whole Aaron Hernandez situation. These people, like, they're just normal people that became, they had fame thrust upon them because they did, like, a couple of things awesome. You kick really good. You throw really well. You can fucking take a punch and you can pretend to be people.
Yeah.
Like, here, let's give you all this money, but let's not teach you how to be responsible with it.
Well, it's the same, but in my mind, it's also like Tiger Woods. Let's teach you how to start playing golf when you're 1.5 years old.
Yeah.
And let's not teach you about, you know, women and how they're actually very important to society, and you probably shouldn't betray the one you choose to be with.
Yeah.
You know, like,
that's exactly what we were talking about.
You know what else
I
think?
Let's give you all
this
cash.
He shouldn't have gotten married right after he became famous.
Yeah,
but he wanted his trophy wife. I mean, some people, they just get to this point that
he could have bought one.
He
basically did.
He did.
He's a freaking model, dude. She had a good career going.
$1 billion.
You don't think Giselle bought Tom Brady?
He has a freaking private island golf course. Like,
most people just get married for sex anyway, so...
The thing is, she probably knew from the get-go, and it just kept piling up, and eventually she's probably like, I want to be... And when the scandals really came out, because Tiger Woods did a good job of hiding his life, but, you know, you can't hide your life. If you're doing anything wrong, you have to be doing it wrong with somebody, unless you're literally killing people or something, like, you know, you can't do drugs alone. You have to buy them from somebody, or unless you're growing your own pot, I guess, That's not really drugs.
You know, I want to say real fast, I think one of the underrated actors that that I haven't really mentioned yet is, I just had a brain fart. The guy, Mel from Firefly.
Nathan Fillion?
Nathan Fillion, Mal? Yeah.
The guy who played Mal.
Yeah, Mal.
Yeah, Nathan Fillion.
Yeah, Nathan Fillion.
What about Adam Baldwin? He was amazing.
that was like a complete. How did you even think of him after seeing him?
Adam Baldwin played Jane. He's
one of the Baldwins I liked.
Yeah, he's
Adam
good
Alec.
Though. He's
I'm
good.
Like, fuck. Well, there's like 20 of them.
Yeah, I know. There's a lot of
Baldwins. Like 20 of them.
Baldwins, no, but... Sheens, and.
Yeah, it's very strange how the Hollywood circle has become.
But yeah, I will say Nathan Fillion, awesome, great actor, but he hasn't been in enough shit for me to be like, oh, he's my favorite. I loved him as Matt, one of my favorite characters.
Just watching him in Firefly was amazing. I even liked him in Castle too. You know, when I was
good in Castle. I loved the episode of Castle where he dressed up as Mal for Halloween.
Yeah, when I was married at the time, I was watching it with my ex. That Castle was very good too for him too. He's a little bigger, but I mean, he just has
but that
this
one
wave.
Throwback scene though, where he dressed as Mal was fucking amazing.
I know,
His
know.
Daughter, yeah, the daughter's like, oh, what are you supposed to be? Space cowboy.
And that's why, like, Firefly reminds me of Cowboy
Bebop. That was like 7 years ago. Let it go.
Who's the guy who plays Hellboy?
Ron Perlman.
Oh yeah, I like
him. Like that guy.
Ron Perlman is awesome, but I feel like he's always the same person.
From Sin City? Yeah, but look at him.
He's got a winning formula, dude. He plays a badass. That's his role. And that's what he does awesome.
I will say, he was in one of the biggest pieces of shit that I've ever watched.
Desperation.
Have you guys ever seen the movie Desperation?
No.
It's based off of one of my favorite Stephen King novels. And it's based at this town out in the, like, this mining town out in the desert that's been taken over by this old ancient demon. And he plays the cop that's like the main character that's possessed by this demon. Hmm. Like he murdered the whole town and he's the one pulling
yeah,
over
I don't know.
People passing through and shit. And he's just, oh my God, it's so horrible.
Dude, unless it's Ghost Rider.
He did a terrible job. The rest of the movie was bad. Like,
did you? Okay, does everybody? I can't think of names right now. It's just escaping me. But, what's his name? He was Ghost Rider for the movie.
Oh, Nicolas Cage.
Does everybody hate him still? Yeah. Why does everybody hate him so much?
You know.
Because
there's a
he
few
can't
times
control
I
the volume to... of his voice.
Yeah, there's a few times I like him because I think he's an all right person again. But man, I can never get into him.
Face off. He was
face
no matter
off was
how
all
hard
right.
you try, you can't get into him. Huh?
Face off was a great
lube. He's lube.
I liked that movie.
I mean, Gone in 60 Seconds was a good movie.
Was good. Face off also good.
Yeah.
But
I wasn't.
I can't
liked
think
it
of
a little
Raising
bit.
Arizona.
Just movies Back like Goat. I feel like he just turns down what he'd be really good at.
I feel like he doesn't turn anything he's ever offered down. Like Ghost Rider, he had no business playing Johnny.
That's Pace. What I'm saying. Ghost Rider was like, dude, come on. That's not you. Like, that's who you want to be. But you're more like movies like National Treasure or whatever. Like.
Yeah, like I'm sorry, Johnny Blaze. Yeah, you could have. Awesome. He could have played Johnny Blaze if they made that movie in the 70s.
I mean, like if you're gonna do like an old person, like why don't you like Harrison Ford as like Ghost Rider or something?
In his 80s,
put Don Rickles up there.
Well, yeah, he would turn into a skeleton pretty fast.
Well, I was talking about when Ghost Rider came out, Harrison Ford, not Harrison Ford now.
Man.
Yeah, like Patrick Swayze towards the end of his life would have been a great Ghost Rider. He was already
yeah. No way.
Too low.
Too smiley.
Too low.
You know, we didn't give him any props. We named so many movies this one guy was in, and we just never, ever, like, said his name, but John Travolta.
John Travolta, definitely.
Travolta does not make my top 10.
Really? Why?
Really?
He was in Grease. Like,
what'd you say?
He was in Grease.
Yeah, that's why.
Yeah. Broken.
No, I mean, I do like Travolta, but I don't know. He's just
gay. Homophobe.
Oh, what? he's definitely a closet gay.
No, Broken Arrow.
That's
is
his
my
rock.
Favorite.
Broken Arrow.
Swordfish.
Swordfish. Yeah, Swordfish is cool.
One of my favorite Travoltas.
That's a good one, too. Broken Arrow is definitely his best acting, I would say.
Hugh Jackman.
See, you
feel like
your contingencies.
Honestly, I feel like John Travolta's whole career is
you keep
the
your
progression
initiative.
Of him as a criminal. Because he started off like, Welcome Back, Connor, as that fucking thug.
Yeah, dude.
You know,
that's why I like him.
Then he just kept going
like the
from there, you know.
Real badass. Like, he could be...
Like, he fucking hijacked a nuke. He was a fucking major crime boss. But before that... Before
and
all
he was
that,
in Punisher.
Yeah, that came before. Yeah, actually, that came after he hijacked the nuke. Huh? So I feel he went backwards a little. But
maybe
he started out as
dead.
Kind of the thug on Welcome Back, Kotter. Then he moved up to Pulp Fiction. He was one of the main guys for Marcellus Wallace.
Mm-hmm. He had,
and then from there, he went out to steal nukes.
No, I can't remember what movie it was where he was. And that with Samuel Jackson again, and that rainy, it was like the guys, they're all military, and they all went out into that, and it was something with drugs, and like they had to keep getting their story straight. And people weren't who they really said they were. Nobody knows this movie.
Nope.
Shit, oh man, it's a good movie. It was like
you're
such
talking
a
about Reservoir Dogs.
No.
No.
I'll look it. I'll say it later to you. We can keep going to other people because it's just a good movie to look up one time. John Travolta and Samuel Jackson. Samuel Jackson plays this character. He got murdered on this military thing. There's like underground stuff out and like, but the rains was coming in really hard, and there was some kind of drug thing that was going on with some of the people. They all knew about it. I think John Travolta was the cop. He was
the
cop.
Military
that,
movie, yeah, where he's
they called him up to bring him.
Oh,
over
the general's daughter.
No, not the general's daughter.
There's no such thing as a code red.
I thought that was it, where he was investigating the murder of the daughter.
It wasn't the general's daughter. It was he was investigating the murder of Samuel Jackson. Samuel Jackson was the person he gets murdered. He was such a hard ass.
I don't remember.
I don't know that one. All right. Brad can look it up.
What's that? Mm-hmm. You said Hugh Jackman, by the way. I want to give him some more props, too.
Meh.
Meh.
He's been Basic. A great Wolverine.
Basic was that name of that movie, by the way.
Basic, yes.
Yep.
Yeah, Hugh Jackman, all I can see him as is Wolverine, and he does a good job. That's what I'm saying.
He's been a great
like
Wolverine.
He's basically just a one-trick pony at this
point. I can't think of any other Hugh Jackman.
Yeah, but he found his
besides
place.
That one in Australia, and that was boring Swordfish. As shit. Oh, yeah, again, Swordfish. You're right. Holy shit.
He was awesome in that movie, too.
I forgot him in that movie. That can't be the same guy.
That is. Yeah. That is Hugh Jackman. Yeah. I totally forgot that was him.
That's why Hugh Jackman is such a good actor, because he knows how to get.
No, but John Travolta trumped his part completely. John Travolta as a badass, even in Broken Arrow, he trumps Slater, Christian Slater's part. Christian Slater is the good guy.
He can't.
And John Travolta like takes up the whole movie as the bad guy.
He can't trump. He can't trump Nicolas Cage in Face Off though. Isn't that who it was?
Nicolas Cage and John Travolta.
He trumps so many characters though.
That's why that movie was still like, it had to happen. But jeez.
Even in Pulp Fiction, he trumps Bruce Willis's part.
Yes, he does.
Right? He trumps Bruce Willis's part. John Travolta himself. Just himself trumps
my favorite Travolta.
Bruce Willis's part completely.
Yeah, but he was supposed to. Bruce Willis wasn't supposed to be a main. Like, he was.
It was a different part of the story that came.
My top fives, because, like, that's a cop out. That's like saying Samuel Jackson's your number one.
No, we already. Sowsauce already said my number one earlier, but I can't think of his name at the moment. No, we didn't talk about him yet. Denzel Washington's probably my favorite actor ever. I just think that he's like the most badass guy, who's still a good guy, but he's sometimes a bad guy.
I actually like bad guy.
What was it? Man on Fire.
Yep.
One of my favorite movies.
That was good though.
Where he fucking shoves the grenade up the guy's ass.
I wish you had more time. Just walks off.
I liked him in Eli. I just thought he did a cool job.
Oh, Book of Eli.
Yeah, Book of Eli. It's like it was just him. It's like for him to have so much screenplay. Like, he did a good job. Never
actually saw it.
Really?
Yeah. Always meant to. It looked good.
Yeah. I like fight scenes that aren't always so crazy, where it's, like, realistic. Like, sometimes all the, like, Jet Li stuff is, I mean, it's good. Like, don't get me wrong, though. We didn't even get into all them. Like, Jackie Chan. Bruce Lee.
Bruce Lee is the best martial artist of anybody, hands down.
Who? Bruce Lee?
Bruce Lee. You watch any of his movies, and it's not that he just gets in a character. He was actually that fucking good at it.
The main dude from the Ong Bak movie.
Yeah, oh, he's awesome. Amazing. He's awesome, but that's Thai.
It's like Johnny
Thai
or
fighting.
Jimmy something or...
No, but you know what? The guy from the
Johnny
Ip Man too.
No, but I know what you're saying.
I haven't seen
what you're saying, Zodiac.
I've seen the Ong Bak.
But him. But he's amazing at Thai fighting, and then you got Bruce Lee is amazing at like Chinese boxing and things like that. But like that's like realistic fighting, and the Thai fighting with the elbows and the knees. Oh my gosh! In those movies. Yeah. The bad guys at the end, they get nailed so many times with the elbows and knees. I'm like, geez, their brain must be like jello at this point.
Oh, I know. Is it elbows and knees, or I thought it was...
It's elbows and knees.
I thought it was forearm and shins.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, dude, if you get the human body to a point where, you know, you can really
fully do. I mean, Sal, you were in gymnastics before. You know, like, you think if you were just trained at birth to do this kind of stuff in generations, man, imagine, like, the capabilities of a true martial artist, like, the back in the, you know, 1600s feudal Japan and stuff. Back when
that was the way of life.
Yeah, you know. Back when that was the way of life. Well, yeah. Like,
fuck, I'm so American, I can barely nowadays. Get in my car some days.
Like, even, like, China as early as the 19th century had just nonstop martial artists that were just reckless.
Yeah, dude, these they still have the these, dude, like...
The Ip Man is the dude who trained Bruce Lee, and Bruce Lee adapted his style to form the style Bruce Lee made.
He made Gung Fu. I believe
the whole kung fu was like Wing Chun or whatever, that this idea of
Wing
like defense
Chun was
it is crazy when you see a master doing that, like, just incredible, like,
watching Bruce Lee flip around, do a kick and flip at the same time, kicking off of somebody's head, that's insane.
Jackie Chan,
gotta watch Ip Man.
You have to watch.
Dude, yeah, I did see that. I always said Ip Man, but
Ip Man.
Yeah,
yo, he IP does man, it effortlessly. And that's the thing. That's like the whole Iron Fist. You know how they're trying to say like the same kind of message. Like, you have to take their energy from them. You're not just fighting them. You take their energy. They don't.
Yeah, but BC, remember, even in Cowboy Bebop, Spike is modeled after Bruce Lee.
Bruce Lee.
And some other gunfighter. I can't remember what the other gunfighter is, but he's modeled after Bruce Lee. But Bruce Lee would say, when you're fighting your enemies, you have to be like water.
Yeah.
Sometimes you have to move as, you know, fluid like a stream, and sometimes you have to come pounding down on an enemy like a
waterfall.
Like a waterfall. So you have to, be fluid with the battle.
Well, that's your body has to always be able to be in a position to move where you need it to move. That's why he always jumped. You know, when he got angry, he would jump, which is like the same. And remember, Chuck Norris did that same thing to keep up at the time.
And you watch how he moves to the enemy. He like creeps upon him a little bit. He's like slowly getting closer and closer. And he's like doing stuff with his hands, or he's moving his hands around as like an illusion. Like, look at this, look at this, look at this, boom. And then there comes
he still would have lost against Kareem Abdul-Jabbar though.
Nah.
If you weren't lucky, they had it.
No,
cripple
he
him
trained
movie,
him,
man.
Dude. He they trained
had,
him.
They had it.
Bruce Lee trained Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Bruce Lee trained Chuck Norris.
Bruce Lee trained
so many people. All these people think they're so famous. All these really famous people that you hear, like Chuck Norris, he was trained by Bruce Lee. That's why he got so famous.
I'm just saying in that movie,
he sparred against Bruce Lee all the time. Yep. He's like, I never. He was just always one step ahead of me.
Which you knew how in the second episode of Cowboy Bebop they immediately modeled, you know, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's fight. You remember that?
Yeah, the one with the dog. Trigger. The one with the dog.
Oh yeah, man.
Remember that?
Which makes me wonder, Trigger, who do you think they modeled Ayn's dad over? Because remember, he just beat Spike, dude.
And bad. And then he leaves him with like an egg. Hard boiled eggs.
Yo, Spike is a beast, but man, this guy's just ripped, and he's so slow compared. Spike just couldn't do anything to him.
I don't know.
Why I like anime sometimes.
I don't know. The Tong Poo one was one of my favorites, though. That was insane. Spike would never have killed that guy if it wasn't for the little cats.
Oh yeah, won that knife. Who would have thought
That was scary to watch.
Why did that happen? And the giant animal stepping on him afterwards. That probably played a part.
It was such a relief to see that, like, oh, gosh.
Speaking of Spike, anybody want to throw Sarah Michelle Gellar out there as a favorite?
With Buffy?
Not really.
No. I did watch Buffy.
I love the movie.
Actor I don't like.
So. I love the movie.
Amy Schumer.
Really?
Ugh.
I hate her comedy too. It's the same shit. She just repeats the same shit over and over
She's
and over again.
She's just so not funny. I watched her latest stand-up special too. I gave her another shot just because it's been so long.
You know what happens when you go to a comedy show and a heckler happens? You love that shit because a comedian roasts the heckler. She just told him to get out. Jade security, yep. Remove him.
Yeah.
I was like, haha, fucking bitch. She couldn't even, she had no comebacks. I was like, come on, this should be great. She's Amy Schumer. She's
but whoever made that song, Milk, Milk, She's Lemonade. Horrible.
That was funny as shit.
That was funny. Whoever made that song, and she did a good job in that. But I don't think she made the song. But if she did make the song, kudos to her for doing that.
Yeah.
You know,
should have just stayed one hit. Should have just stayed a one hit wonder doing that. You probably would have made more.
I want to ask you guys.
I feel like her show was kind of funny because she did, the funny interviews.
But you have to remember, at that point in time, it's probably not just her show. It's probably other producers who are contributing lots of money to do it, and you know, another team that's like, we should do this. Yeah. We're gonna have this. You know, I'm just saying, like, stand-up comedy. Look at Dave Chappelle. Like, his stand-up comedy isn't really as funny anymore as it's more just, like, a serious message about racism. Like, I don't know. That's how I feel about Dave Chappelle.
You're right. He absolutely is yeah. You know, goes into that. I
stand-up,
think
Chris, his newest stand-up was hilarious.
Stand-up comedy
I watched both of new two-part
Kevin
stand-up.
Hart has just taken it. Stand-up comedy
I think the funniest one he...
Hysterical.
BC, the funniest one he did was with the Ku Klux Klan, where he was a black guy, but he was blind, and he was the head leader of the Ku Klux Klan.
Oh, yeah, back in the day on Chappelle's show. That shit was hilarious, yeah.
Once he took his helmet off, one of the...
If anyone's gonna have sex with my sister, it's gonna be me.
he took his hat off once.
After
and
25
one of the guy's heads exploded.
Why, after 25 years of marriage, would you leave your wife? Simply responded, she was a nigger lover.
I wasn't going to finish that one. I was going to let you see.
Don't care. Yeah, you know
that's
what I learned?
How the show goes.
But I do want to throw this out there because I mentioned Buffy earlier. Did I tell you guys that Juliet Landau follows us on Twitter?
Who?
Really?
Yeah, she played Landau? Drusilla on Buffy. Spike's crazy-ass girlfriend.
Actually, I did watch a few Buffys, but it was like before watching TV. I was actually playing a lot outside at that point in time.
Well, that's
like,
awesome.
I'll blame Juliet Landau for why I didn't have any friends in high school, because her Drusilla character was this crazy-ass hot goth girl, basically.
Well, there you go, Zodiac. You just ruined it. Now she's gonna unsubscribe.
What's her name again? Because
I just called her crazy ass hot too. So that's gonna help her.
Crazy ass hot potatoes. Okay.
Juliet Landau. That's who.
Look her up.
Well, we hope you're having a great day, and we hope you're enjoying this little podcast we got going here.
Yeah.
It was all for you.
The entire show.
DM me.
Ooh, it's spelled with an AU.
No, that was you, Zodiac.
But set something up.
See, you're just trying to make it sound bad so she'll fall in love with you or something.
You know what? I'm going to be 100% honest. I could probably talk my wife into it.
You know, I'll be honest too. I could see this.
Yeah, if she definitely watches this episode now, she's probably gonna be like, okay, creeps to buy.
She's like, unsubscribe.
I'm okay with that. I got to confess my love.
Hey, at least you got to say, you know.
Flash West.
I confess my
love
for Ava Mendes,
That's one thing you gotta do before you die. You gotta make sure you get all your jollies out and, you know, say everything you need to say.
I can't remember if my wife and I agreed on a pass or not, if I was able to be with Ava Mendes. It was like only one, but I think hers is like Bradley Cooper or something. I should probably ask her again, actually. I should probably make that deal, just in case. Because now it's just going to be friends.
Honestly,
he happens to be like, yo, listen to this whole episode.
Like, hey, who do you want to fuck if you ever had the chance? Like,
no,
we never talked about that.
These well, it definitely assholes. Would be Mila Jovovich for me. I would say that.
I will say she's attractive, but she's not my type.
I think me and her could hit it off very well.
Oh, there's. I'll put it like this. I don't think there's a single person in Hollywood, single female in Hollywood anyway, that's not like beautiful. You know, that's not like attractive. Even like Lindsay Lohan. And I don't even think like Emma Watson is like, everyone's got a big thing for Emma Watson. I don't see it. I think she's attractive, but I don't see like everybody's thing.
Yeah, Scarlett Johansson.
Was it Jim Carrey who was like obsessed with Emma Stone? He made that weird YouTube video.
Yeah.
Like,
really?
You know what?
Jim Carrey kind of got the wrong kind of weird towards the end of his career.
Zodiac kind of just did like the same thing. Come on, Zodiac, what else would you do to this? Juliet Landau.
I didn't say I'd do anything to her.
All I said was
that if that was ever a possibility, because
Jim Carrey did get a little weird towards the end of his career.
Yeah.
I wonder why. It makes you always wonder again, because like I said, you know, I watched this one 20-minute video on YouTube that talked about how like every Hollywood person had to be gay and stuff. Like it was like a rite of passage practically.
No, but I think
long this video.
I think what you have to know about the actors, especially the comedians and stuff, is when you're a comedian and you're in Hollywood and you're doing this kind of stuff, you have to constantly come up with comedic stuff to still be in that spotlight, you know. And after a while, it either makes you go overboard or it makes you get depressed, you know, like with Robin Williams.
Well, yeah. All right.
But I almost literally think that Robin Williams was killed. I don't think he killed himself. I just don't see that.
No.
I don't see that.
Dude,
I don't see him killing himself.
I don't think he was killed. Another one.
I think a lot of comedy to depression.
A lot of comedians are clinically depressed.
Yo, they see the truth, and when you start seeing this like truth in such a depressing light, it's daunting. And when you realize that, you know, I mean, I'm not gonna like say everything,
but
because
it seemed like it was such a personal thing for him to make jokes.
Another Netflix thing. Look up Neil Brennan, Three Mics. It's a really awesome stand-up on Netflix, and this dude, like, he was a writer for the Chappelle Show, and he just goes into everything from just straight up jokes and comedy to talking about his battles with depression and alcoholic fathers and all this shit.
It really
tells you like the true story of like a lot of these people who are out there in LA.
That's kind of why when you know,
you
like
think
these
it's just
famous
because it's
people,
California.
That's what I'm saying. These famous people were getting so
a lot of people
in
California are just kind of crazy, anyway.
And everybody's like all like this and that, but it's like,
well,
you know what?
That's
like
the kind of people that are drawn to fame.
If they stopped doing all that, though, like what would we all be doing? If every one of them were just like, we're just not going to do like television anymore. Like famous football people, are like I'm not saying they shouldn't be doing it.
I'm just saying.
They get paid a lot of money.
They do get paid a shitload.
Obscene
amounts. Yes.
Like, why don't one of you move out to my town and just start fixing it up? Like, I don't like this damn sidewalk. You know
like
what?
$10,000.
I can endorse something right here. You know, I don't
maybe
know.
You
I'm
could
just
get
saying,
Shia LaBeouf to do that.
These big fancy houses. Are you employing?
Holy shit! That guy went off the rails fast.
Yeah.
Shia LaBeouf. Well, not that fast. You did a lot of things. You got overwhelmed.
I wanted to ask you what like some of your favorite genres are, because for me, it's like a cowboy western or it's a spaghetti western. But I think Kurt Russell in Escape from L.A. really portrays that very well.
Oh, again, oh man, how could we not say this guy's name? Dude, go ahead, talk about Kurt Russell. But if nobody mentions him next, because
Bruce Campbell was in that movie too for a small little scene.
Yep.
But I mean, the whole Western part where he's just drawing his double guns, and one of the best parts was like, when this can hits the ground, draw. And he throws it up in the air and he shoots them real fast, and then the can hits the ground. He's like, draw.
Yeah.
I mean, that
and
kind
everyone
of
around there's like, oh shit, I'm not gonna call him out on that.
I mean, that kind of Western style. I mean, that's really my. That's my theme, you know, that spaghetti western or
right. And that's why Firefly
style
was so awesome, because it was
Trigger
that style in the future.
Yeah, yeah. Trigger, do you have one guess on who you think as soon as you said the western thing, who you think
John
has any
Wayne?
Clue? Like, again, with all the movies that this guy was in, and we didn't name this guy. right. Christopher Walken.
Last Man Standing.
Again, I felt it was a cop out if I put him in there. Because he's been in so many awesome movies. There's just, yeah. You can't deny that Walken is amazing.
Yeah. I mean, Chris.
Suicide Kings is one of my favorite.
Even on
movies
SNL,
ever
he's
made.
Hilarious. You know?
Oh, yeah, the Don't Fear the Reaper sketch.
No, the one where he's trying to tempt the women to come into his apartment all the time.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
I forgot all about that shit.
She goes into the bathroom and he has a see-through mirror with his bathroom and he lights a lighter like he's gonna watch her while she's going to the bathroom. He's like, oh, he turns it off and he comes out. And he's, but you never see the woman. It's just the camera he's talking to.
Right.
Movie I like Christopher Walken in? Wedding Crashers. I really enjoyed his role in Wedding Crashers. He doesn't ever seem to do like a huge, long role in too many movies. You know why I thought about it, though?
Seven Psychopaths was awesome, too.
As soon as you said the old Westerns, you made me think of him. Christopher Walken from with Bruce Willis. What was the movie called, Trigger? I can't think of it at the time.
Last Man Standing.
Yeah. That's a great
classic. One. Absolute classic. This is so underrated that people probably
a lot. I don't feel like it's underrated anymore.
Well, we've been talking about it, but not on this show. We haven't talked about it that much. But this is one of those other underrated movies that people have not gone out to see. I don't think.
Well, that's because that long shooting. Dude, he shot like, I think he counted like 30 bullets.
Bruce Willis.
His six shooter never ran out of bullets.
I don't think before he went out, dude. He made so many ammo clips.
Listen, that
he made like he had 12 ammo clips.
That movie came out. Stallone was coming out
boom. And that's modeled after
an
older
Arnold
movie.
Schwarzenegger was coming out with movies and stuff like that. It was just the wrong time for that movie to come
and Zodiac,
out.
I just watched Terminator with my kid last week.
Does he have nightmares?
Yeah, right. Are you kidding me? He was so underwhelmed by Terminator. Like,
yeah, dude. When that
he
thing
was,
goes
when
into
he's
lava,
heard about it, he fucking thing, thought all the soundboards were hilarious, so he wanted to see the movie. We watched Terminator. He's like, Dad, these graphics suck. Like, yeah, that's because they're not graphics, son. These are
claymation
effects.
Wasn't like claymation
CGI,
mixed in with robots.
Like when the Terminator, like after all the skin melted off, and it was just the fucking endoskeleton chasing after him. He's like, you can tell it's an action figure. I can see the wires. I'm like, yeah, I'm sorry, kid. This movie came out the year I was born.
I'm not going to lie,
though.
This
movie is 33 years old.
I saw that movie when I was like 6.
Yeah, like, it was fucking terrifying.
And it was terrifying, man. I had nightmares freaky day. I definitely had a nightmare about that one. I was like, oh my gosh.
Yeah,
They did a good thing kind of spinning that around.
It's so like would you say that's a Western or a future?
And
that?
Then like the next one was even
the
worse.
Only Terminator.
Time travel?
Yes.
Time travel? I don't know.
The second one, just again, that's why I said there's so many I mean, we should have a series on sequels that sucked.
Well, no, Terminator 2 was awesome.
I'm just saying,
as far as special effects go, like, it really didn't get much better.
The only thing that was good about Terminator was the game that came out after that.
Oh, Die Hard. Die Hard sequel that sucked. Come on, Die Hard. Die Harder.
Die Hard definitely was good.
Oh my god, yeah. Die Hard is where that needed to end.
Are you guys kind of following the Western theme? Do you guys think these are Westerns too? Or
and
like,
then you
what
made
are
a four?
Like?
What the hell are you thinking? And then you made a four? Like, hey, 10 years later, hey, let's make a four. I have no other ideas. But there's tons of other ideas. When Harold and Kumar go to White Castle, I want to know what those other two Jewish guys went to Hot Dog Heaven. I want to know how they met that Asian chick from that party. I want to know. I want to know. You owed it to me. And you couldn't think of it? You guys are supposed to be from Hollywood. Supposed to be so smart and think of it. Nobody walked past and said, hey, I have a funny idea, dude. And it's like, you know, I can make that actually happen. Let me just call, what's that blonde haired guy's name that I, Neil Patrick Harris. I bet that guy can make anything happen.
NPH.
Yeah. We need some cocaine. Call Neil Patrick Harris, man.
complicated.
So I guess BC, for you, it's comedy, right? Comedy's your wheelhouse?
He's probably like, I'm not into any kind of drugs.
I don't watch a lot of Westerns, Frank, but I do enjoy action movies.
Yeah, I do too.
So some of them are classified as Westerns, like Last Man Standing. Tombstone. Fucking love Tombstone.
Oh, yeah. That was great.
And, I don't know. It was No Country for Old Men.
Val Kilmer's best part was in Tombstone.
Classified as a Western.
I'd say so.
It's based up there.
What? Say that again?
No Country for Old Men.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that would be kind of Western.
Kind of Western-y.
Yeah. So, Thousand Ways to Die in the Old West is hilarious.
Holy Christ, I love that movie. just that one non-stop scene with the ice block where he's explaining.
Yep.
They chisel it out of the Boston Harbor and then it shipped all the way out here. It was actually like five times this size. Oh my God! It just fucking crushes that dude's skull. Like, it's so fucking amazing.
I like all the guys from the Happy Madison productions.
Yeah, like you were saying earlier, Adam Sandler.
Yeah.
I hate old Sandler.
You tell me you didn't like Billy Madison? Like, or again, Happy Gilmore?
I thought that was okay. Happy Gilmore, I like the best.
I like parts of them. I can't watch the whole movie, though. Like, it's just too stupid.
As soon as that animation came out, when he went through that huge, I'm Jewish, make sure everybody knows it phase. You know, it's like, we all think you're Jewish, dude.
Pretty much anything after Spanglish is okay.
Well, he didn't do the Jewish hammer or the whatever.
The Hebrew hammer? No, that was the Adam Carolla.
Yeah.
Adam Carolla, man. Adam Carolla's a guy. He's funny.
The Hebrew hammer.
He's a funny act. That guy's a funny. I wish I could meet that guy, Adam. He just looks like he's so much. Yeah. He just looks like. Yeah, that guy.
The
just,
Office?
What was that scene? I don't remember what it was where he played like some senile guy and he's like, I'm waiting for. I can't remember who it was. Oh yeah, how can we not name this guy either? Gosh, because I can never remember his name. He played the animal in The Animal.
He was also Deuce Bigelow.
Right? Yeah. What is his name? Rob Schneider.
I
used to hate him, but wait till you watch the show. His TV shows. Did you ever watch his TV shows on Netflix? He will turn.
That's a huge bitch.
Dude, he has a show called Rob, his wife, like he has an attractive wife. Like his show is funnier than, it's his real life. It's his real life. It's his genuine life.
I'll look it up. It's on Netflix, Rob?
It used to be.
That's easy to remember.
There was another
one. You know that?
Type in, because there was another show. He did one in Spanish that me and my wife watched a long time ago. And then he did another show in English that's more new. And because I guess the one in Spanish was a hit, you know. So they did it again in English. They realized that people enjoy his real life is more funny than all the movies he's ever done. Like people, like he walks around and everybody's like, "You're Rob Schneider," like all this stuff to him, like all the time. He's like, "Yeah, I know. Thanks, dipshit." Yo, he gave a $5 tip to a coffee guy. He got a coffee and gave a $5 tip. The guy's like, $5? He's like, "Yeah, I just got a coffee." He's like, "You're Rob Schneider." He's like, "How are you just gonna give me $5? I work in a freaking coffee shop." Starts this whole. He's like, "You, we should give me $20." He's like, "Dude, I don't even fucking work anymore." He's like, "I don't have fucking $20 even in my pocket right now." Like, it's just all these scenes keep happening to him. Like, he's funny. He's funny in real life. And his wife is freaking attractive. I just would put it out there. His wife is attractive. She's really attractive, and it plays a lot against him.
I kind of anything he's ever done.
Me neither. I really didn't like too many of the things he's done. He played a few funny little short clips, but
What was the movie where they all got together after high school?
Oh, with Adam Sandler and Grown-Ups. Yeah.
Yeah, I liked him in that. He was good in that role.
You know why? Because, like, yeah, I think those guys, like,
because he was a tame fucking dumbass. He wasn't,
and we didn't even name. Yo, did you hear Charlie Murphy died?
Yeah.
What the heck, man? Charlie Murphy. Because I didn't mention Eddie Murphy or Chris Rock. So many funny black people. They're all funny. You're all funny. If you're black and you're funny, you're funny. I could name all of you. But I'm serious. There's not too many black people I watch that are famous that you know have like funny things going. You know, if you're just a comedian, you're black, and you're just talking about constant race, I don't think you're that funny.
Yeah. Well, the thing is, like, I've seen a lot of Chris Rock, and after a while,
Steve Harvey,
hearing Chris,
yeah,
Chris
Rock, and everybody, I get Chris Rocked out real fast.
Well, he talks about is race in most of his comedic stuff, and after a while, like, you start to see it, and you're like, yeah, I think he might be somewhat racist.
Yeah, Chris Rock ain't for white people, and that's funny. I like that. That's about it. That's what he is about. I'm just saying, I know it, but black people got to have a spokesperson, and Chris Rock does a good job of doing it, and he's not too rude.
Yeah, but it looks a little borderline.
I agree with you, but I think
Chappelle sums it up real good.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's what he's definitely. Yo, in that scene,
he's back.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, me too. I miss Dave Chappelle, man. Dave Chappelle was a funny guy throughout my childhood.
He's the shit. But you guys really didn't like go into like what your favorite genres are and all that. You know, I talked about my Westerns, but I didn't hear anything from you guys. Like Rob, you said, like, actions. And I see that, too. John Wick.
I do like a lot of action movies, but I would say that horror is my all-time favorite genre. It's just
been letting me
down for the past, decade.
Is Hellraiser your favorite series, or what?
Halloween is my favorite series.
Halloween?
Well, all right. Zodiac. How about this?
Is probably number two.
Zodiac, because I agree with you that horror movies have just kind of—they just keep getting more digital and confusing.
It's not like, scary anymore.
The previews and know what happens the entire way through. Now
you know the last movie that I thought was absolutely like just like disgusting. Oh, like, oh, this is fucking scary. Was the I just lost.
Well, Zodiac, would you say due to special effects, horror movies have actually gone?
They've gotten worse.
They're not possible anymore. Do you think we need to start making like horror houses?
We need just more practical effects. Like Walking Dead does a lot of practical effects, and it looks gory and disgusting, and that's why they get complaints. These PG-13 R-rated horror movies that have been coming out lately. There's no practical effects. There's no gore.
So you need gore to be scared?
Not so much gore, but if you're gonna rip somebody's arm apart or something like that, like it needs to be practical effects. They're just,
tired of
dying at all.
I'm just tired of flashing and then people getting like, how many times am I gonna have to see the lights go out and then the lights turn back on and now there's somebody there in the corner that it's like, oh, there it is. Lights go out, lights come back on. Oh, there he's going.
Like, just made a whole movie. Lights out.
You know, I mean, like
the movie,
like the well. What's the girl comes out of the TVs and the well and all that. Ring. Like the ring, like that was, you know, pretty well done again. But it's, you know, like how many times anything that's old they make more scary. You know,
well,
I don't know.
Done in Japanese way. That's Evil for Japanese folks.
I just think it's done. I think horror movies are done, and we're gonna start seeing like horror houses and stuff, like places you can go.
Well,
where
the
they
thing
have,
is,
CGI
like you have, like what Rob,
scary.
Like so, but Brett, like what Zodiac's saying, you have three directions you have to go. You have to go very traditional, and very you know normal kind of gore, you know that looks realistic, or you have to go the Bruce Campbell way, of Evil Dead. And just go completely blatantly, you know,
campy.
Like fuck you. It's just gonna be like this. Or you gotta go Godzilla way, you know, where it's just completely spectacular and just over the top.
Well, no, there's also the like the mind fuck aspect.
Ah, sure, yeah.
Like
that's also lacking lately.
What about
every horror movie in the past like decade, you can call everything that's gonna happen.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. Like, what's the Saw series? Like, they went out of hand. Yeah. If they would have just stuck with maybe one, they would have been fine. Like, they went like eight. Like,
yeah, Saw went too far.
And then that's what I'm saying. Saw destroyed it almost. It was, you know, they destroyed that whole. They were good. They were all kind of good in a sense.
Still haven't
look
seen
at the Human Centipede. The Human.
Human centipede.
Oh gosh, that probably as far as gross factor is probably top for last decade.
But the first one though is genuinely scary because you have to think like I know there's people were dumb, but you have to think
the first
like,
one was
like is that what's going to become scary? Just somebody who's just like you know. Oh, like we're gonna go and get some of this drugs and this and that.
Because
well, and then it's just like the person's like
now.
Just grabs
them
by a
superstitious
van,
anymore.
Grabs them by a van and drugs them, and then it's like the torture. It's torture. The only scary
drug.
You know, you don't need gore with torture. Torture always irks me, man. I see somebody, somebody get their nuts being exploded or something.
Saw is torture porn.
Oh, yeah. The first one was the best, and as they went on, it just turned into this torture thing where it's like all you're going to watch is the person that survived. It's like Final Destination. Like the first person, the last person that died
from the beginning,
is the first person that's going to die. And then you got some people that are going to survive. Most of them are going to die. It's like I could tell what's going to happen, but it's just watching torture after a while.
Yeah.
Like the first Saw really was the one that should have stopped.
That's what
it
I'm
looked like it could have continued, but it should have stopped right fucking there. You know? It got too carried away.
You can make
way.
I can see how you can make three, but yeah, it really did get
was,
like.
I feel like the second one was okay, and then after that, like Saw 1, Saw 2. That's all we need.
It was like they already had all the equipment and they had extra fake blood and stuff in storage. Like, we could just produce a real low budget. And get people to buy it. Like $20,000. All we need is $20,000. We can definitely get that. You know, like do that stuff. Mm-hmm. That'll make your bundle series be $100 instead of just $50. Yeah. Let's do that.
You know what's crazy is because the actor that was the doctor in the first Saw, he was the main actor in Princess Bride. And he was super, he was really good in that movie, but it's like over the years he just stopped doing stuff because The Princess Bride sold so well. And then he decided to come back and he was like in a horror film. So I'm like, it just seems odd, you know?
You know a movie I always liked? That movie with Forrest Whitaker where it kept showing the same scene over and over again and how
Phone Booth?
This person got assassinated.
Phone Booth.
I've never seen that movie.
Phone Booth was good. I liked Phone Booth, where Colin Farrell, Colin Farrell, he's in a phone booth and, you know, he's constantly calling this. That's a great movie where he's just stuck in his phone booth because an assassin's going to kill his ass because he kind of wants to cheat on his wife.
Well, again, that's kind of like that scariness. Like, what if that shit happened to you? Like, what if you were doing
that,
something
that's
bad?
Almost a horror, but that's kind of a thriller. Yeah, that was pretty intense, that whole movie. It's just in the phone booth, the whole movie. You know?
Yeah.
I'd say I like thrillers a little more than horrors because it's like, it's more psychological, makes you think a lot. You know, like, but I don't know. I'd say the last.
We didn't really talk about Ashton Kutcher a lot, too. I always liked Ashton Kutcher.
Yeah, we did mention that. I said I don't care for that guy.
Really?
No.
I used to like him. I guess he was another one of those people who was all about the. Against Kevin Trump, Costner. Right?
I don't know. It's just
awesome. Yeah.
He's like a scene. Oh, fuck! What's his name? Guy that's in the. I mean, they're both in Three Men or. What is that? He was in.
Kevin Costner was in something I just watched recently.
Oh, I can't remember right now. Whatever. What's his name? Charlie Sheen. It's like Ashton Kutcher is like a younger Charlie Sheen, but he's not
at
that level.
He'll get there, but yeah, but Ashton Kutcher does a lot of good things though. He's a pretty nice guy, but he's also like really a big activist with a lot of things that. I think he was one of the people that was like not my president. I don't really support any person who is like not my president because he is.
I think that's kind of stupid.
If it's a false statement, it's
not your president, then also not your country, not your democracy,
exactly,
not your walls,
not your president. That means you're moving out of the country.
Yeah, not your anything to do with these borders. Not your borders, you know. Not your social security number. you know.
Yeah, if you don't like where you're living, you can leave. It's not, you know. Well, some countries let you do that, some don't. But
go get dual citizenship if you want to do that. Then I mean, I guess probably they probably all freaking have dual citizenship. You have so much money, how can you not also decide to go
become
a citizen somewhere else?
Hey, Sal, we haven't heard from you about your favorite genre.
Me?
Sal.
Oh, Sal. Anime is your favorite genre?
Yep.
Japanime? What's your favorite anime? SAO?
That's a good one. No.
Lionheart?
Titan?
Probably Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood. The Hellsing remix is really good too.
Hellsing is great. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the Iron Fist is really cool.
Sorry, I went dead.
Oh, did you just text me?
What was I watching where they did all these different hand signs to do? Oh, it was like Naruto and stuff, right?
Are we still...
Naruto does all them hand signs.
I can't check my phone from here. But
yo, I believe in the future we'll be able to control our chi better with machines. Our machines will control the chi machines.
You know what? You know what I've just figured out, guys?
So we'll be able to blast laser beams out of them.
No. Everything is based on magnets.
We're getting off topic, Trigger.
No magnets.
Well, you're talking about the future.
Magnets, how do they work?
No.
Electricity is manipulated magnetics.
Famous people.
I think it's time to pack it in.
Yeah, if we didn't name you and you're famous, we didn't care.
About you're not sorry. Fucking famous.
You're sorry.
If we didn't, if we didn't list you, you're not famous. Try harder.
All right, what's the guy's name from Family Guy though? I liked him.
Get
too.
Get good, son. What?
What's the guy's name from Family Guy? Because we didn't name his name.
Seth MacFarlane.
Yeah, I like him too. Seth MacFarlane's pretty funny.
I don't classify him as a favorite actor. Like he. He has a couple of cartoons that he does his own voice work for, and then
he does a Robot Chicken, right?
But those cartoons made me laugh a lot.
Yeah, they're hilarious.
Well, that's Seth Green.
I wouldn't put him top five.
Yeah,
I'll give him an honorable mention.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I named like 100 people, so top 100. Yeah. There we are.
I know, we just kept going.
Top,
we definitely named more than
people
five.
I named was my list.
I'm sure everybody's.
Order.
Yeah, I'm sure some people can comment and leave it down below as to what their favorite actors, actresses are, and stuff like that. We didn't get into your little topic, BC, about who are your least favorite or who sucks. We didn't say that.
Next episode. No? Who do we hate in Hollywood?
Yeah, we could go on for that.
Who just fucking sucks?
We already mentioned George Clooney. I love him and I hate him. That's kind of the thing about him. So.
Yeah, but you just want to bang him.
That's. I like that. I'm like, what's her name from American Dad?
What? That one episode, yeah, where Francie wants to like hate fuck George Clooney.
Yeah, what about Matt Groening? Even though he didn't make American Dad, but Matt Groening, man, like, did he make American Dad? He didn't make American Dad. That was also Seth MacFarlane, right? Well, he made American Dad. But Matt Groening is also really funny. Did you like Futurama?
I hear swinging doors in the back.
Really? No.
Futurama's great.
Well,
yes.
I mean, did you like The Simpsons?
Yeah. I liked them for a little while, then after they, made 100 million seasons, I was like, yeah.
Yeah, I'm probably like 8 seasons behind on episodes.
It's like, will you people ever die? Your season never ends.
Oh, and Keanu Reeves, if you're waiting for us to name you, you're on the next episode, just so you know.
Right. And I will also say that because I've already said his name too many times, but
I like the John Wick movie, so John Wick and Chain Reaction, those are your best ones. So,
but Bill and Ted,
that was good. Yeah.
Speed.
Meh. All right, Bullock. Let's wrap it up. Sandra Bullock. I'm the Zodiac. I'm the Zodiac on the Twitters.
Fucker.
That's where he always is.
It's never going away.
Yeah. So
that's where you'll find all the latest up to date info that I feel like posting about while I poop.
Mm-hmm. And Infamous BC is here, and Sowsauce is here too, and I'm Trigger, and also Zodiac, I wanted to mention too. I did get the minds.com site up and running, and I got a little page for us there, so I will post stuff there so you can go and fuck with all that stuff too.
Shoot me a link. So
I will. I'll have it in the description down below. You can check that out. We'll be there also. So minds.com is kind of like in between a Twitter and a Facebook, but it's like more realistic in the sense they won't monitor your shit, I guess. I don't know. But it's like a new website that's come up. It's probably going to be somewhat popular. I'm going to just say it's going to be popular. So
let's do it. Let's embrace it. It's going to be awesome.
It's going to be amazing.
Let's get involved, guys. Let's all get involved. Because that's what my next message is about, getting involved. And how we can do that. Make it happen.
All right.
Sorry. So I don't know when that episode will be. Four episodes.
Yeah, that'll be episode 236. And we'll do that one.
There you go.
But, I've already marked my online calendar.
So yeah, I'm on YouTube. You can find my channel, VeracityTrigger. Watch it there. So I guess next week we're gonna do opposites of movies, actors we like, or what? What are we set to do? Still on the board?
Getting active, if we don't have any other topics. Getting active. It's summertime. How are we going to get active? Okay. What are we doing?
Fishing.
Fishing, absolutely. But we don't have to talk about it all. Talk about it next week, right?
Okay. Awesome.
Bring it up. I already mentioned it. It's in. I'm not even going to be there.
Yeah. Like usual. I'm going to make a topic I'm not going to show up for, asshole.
So let's go with the usual. We'll wig it. Watch Twitter.
Zodiac will tell everybody. Probably before.
I always do.
He'll spoil it. So.
Hang up already.
All right. Peace.
Goodbye. All right, see ya.